This video is created by Jagrat Creations. It is on profit prior to incorporation, hence useful to the students who are reading for CA Intermediate, ICW Executive, CS Executive, BCom and CIPCC. I want to solve one sum on profit prior to incorporation. Just observe the sum on the screen. Firm Messrs. Alag, which was carrying on business from 1st of July 2015, gets itself incorporated as a company on 1st of November 2015. The first accounts are drawn up to 31st of October 2016. So from 1st of July to 31st October 2016 is the first accounting period. So from 1st July to 31st of March, total number of months are 9 and first accounts are drawn only for 9 months. Gross profit for the period 56,000. General expense is 14,220. Director fee is 12,000. Incorporation expense is 1,500. Rent up to 31st of December 1,200 per annum, after which it is increased to 3,000 per annum. Salary of our manager, who upon incorporation of the company was made director, is rupees 6,000 per annum. Per annum expense is given to you. Rent is also given to you per annum, and the accounting period is just of 9 months. His remuneration thereafter is included in the above figure of fees of directors. Give a statement showing pre and post incorporation profit. Net sales is 8,20,000. Monthly average, which for the first 4 months is one half of that of remaining period. Company earned uniform profit. Interest and tax may be ignored. Now for the purpose of solving this sum, first I will work out time ratio. Because time relevant expenses are required to be distributed between pre and post incorporation period on the basis of time. Now, what is the date on which the business is purchased? 1-7-2015. Date of incorporation, 1st November 1-11. Accounting year ends on 31st of March. Number of months prior to incorporation, 1-7-1-11, 4 months. Post incorporation period, 1-11 to 31st of March, 5 months. Time ratio, 4:5. I will write down this time ratio in a corner because I am going to use that while solving the sum. Now I want to work out sales ratio so that I can distribute sales relevant expenses in the ratio of sales. Here bifurcation is made for pre-incorporation period, post-incorporation period. As you know that pre-incorporation months are 4 and post-incorporation months are 5. So these are the 4 months pre-incorporation. Incorporation took place on 1st of November. So from 1st of November onwards, post-incorporation period proceeds. And that is up to 31st of March 2016. Now sales for first 4 months, is suppose 100, then for remaining 5 months it's double. So this is one half of post incorporation monthly sale. So 200 200 200, 400, 1000, 5 to 10 1000, ratio is 4:10, reduced to 2:5. This is the sales ratio that I write in the corner. Now I want to prepare a statement for bifurcation of expenses and income between pre and post incorporation period. Gross profit is 56,000. Bifurcated in the sales ratio, 2:5, 2/7, 16,000. 5 by 7, 40,000. General expenses distributed in the proportion of time, 6320, 7900. Director fees per annum 12,000. And how many months are there in a post-incorporation period? 5 months. So what is the proposed fees for 5 months? That is post-incorporation. Incorporation expenses post-incorporation period. Rent 1200. Rent up to 31st of December 1200. So these are the pre-incorporation months. These are the post-incorporation months. Up to 31st of December, it was 1200 per month. So per month 100 rupees. And after that, 3000 per annum. So 3000 divided by 12 per month 250. So after 31st of December 250. So these 3 months 250. And this 4 plus 2, 6 months, 100. And here it will be 250. These are the pre-incorporation months. 950 total of this post-incorporation rent, 950. So 400 and 950, this is how rent is bifurcated. Salary of a manager. Number of months in pre-incorporation period, 4 months. So 12 months. Salary 6,000. How much for 4 months? 2,000. Pre-incorporation. Now, from this income, expenses are deducted. So you will get the net profit to be transferred to, in case of pre-incorporation, to capital reserve. And in case of post-incorporation, it's a revenue profit. This is how bifurcation of net profit is made between pre and post incorporation period. I feel that you have followed all these things. Thanks to all of you.